Mr. President, there are one or two points I'd like to make, if I may.
Go ahead, General.
One, our hopes for recalling the 843rd Bomb Wing are quickly being reduced to a very low order of probability.
Two, in less than 15 minutes from now, the Ruskies will be making radar contact with the planes. Three, when they do, they are going to go absolutely ape, and they're going to strike back with everything they got. Four, if, prior to this time, we have done nothing further to suppress their retaliatory capabilities, we will suffer virtual annihilation. Now, five, if, on the other hand, we were to immediately launch an all-out and coordinated attack on all their airfields and missile bases, we'd stand a damn good chance of catching them with their pants down. Hell, we got a 5-to-1 missile superiority as it is. We could easily assign 3 missiles to every target and still have a very effective reserve force for any other contingency. Six, an unofficial study which we undertook of this eventuality indicated that we would destroy 90% of their nuclear capabilities. We would therefore prevail and suffer only modest and acceptable civilian casualties from the remaining force, which would be badly damaged and uncoordinated.
General, it is the avowed policy of our country never to strike first with nuclear weapons.
Well, Mr. President, I would say that General Ripper has already invalidated that policy.
That was not an act of national policy, and there are still alternatives left open to us.
Mr. President, we are rapidly approaching a moment of truth, both for ourselves as human beings and for the life of our nation. Now, truth is not always a pleasant thing. But it is necessary now to make a choice, to choose between two admittedly regrettable, but nevertheless distinguishable post-war environments. One, where you got 20 million people killed, and the other, where you got 150 million people killed.
You're talking about mass murder, General, not war.
Mr. President, I'm not saying we wouldn't get our hair mussed, but I do say no more than 10 to 20 million killed, tops, depending on the breaks.
I will not go down in history as the greatest mass murderer since Adolf Hitler.
Perhaps it might be better, Mr. President, if you were more concerned with the American people than with your image in the history books.
General Turgeson, I think I've heard quite sufficient from you. Thank you very much.
Mr. President, they have the ambassador waiting upstairs.
Oh, good. Any difficulty?
They say he's having a fit about that squad of MPs.
Yes, well, that can't be helped. Have him brought down here straight away.
Yes, sir.
Is that the Russian ambassador you're talking about?
Yes, it is, General.
Am I to understand the Russian ambassador is to be admitted entrance to the war room?
That is correct. He is here on my orders.
I don't know exactly how to put this, sir, but are you aware of what a serious breach of security that would be? I mean, you'll see everything. You'll see the big board.
That is precisely the idea, General. That is precisely the idea. Staines, get Premier Kissoff on the hotline.
Survival kit contents check. In them you'll find 1.45 caliber automatic, 2 boxes of ammunition, 4 days concentrated emergency rations, 1 drug issue containing antibiotics, morphine, vitamin pills, pep pills, sleeping pills, tranquilizer pills, 1 miniature combination Russian phrase book and Bible, $100 in rubles, $100 in gold, 9 packs of chewing gum, 1 issue of prophylactics, 3 lipsticks, 3 pair of nylon stockings.
Shoot, a fella could have a pretty good weekend in Vegas with all that stuff.
You don't have any fresh fish?
I'm afraid not, sir.
Your eggs, then, they are fresh?
Oh, yes, sir.
I will have poached eggs. And bring me some cigars, please. Havana cigars.
And that will be all for you, sir?
Yes.
And I'll see to it right away.
Try one of these Jamaican cigars, Ambassador. They're pretty good.
Thank you, no. I do not support the work of imperialist stooges.
Oh, only commie stooges, huh?
Mr. President. You're gonna let that lousy commie punk vomit all over us like this?
Mr. President?
We haven't been able to reach Premier Kissoff in the Kremlin. They say they don't know where he is and won't be back for another 2 hours.
Try BA86543 Moscow.
Yes, sir.
You would never have found him through his office, Mr. President. Our premier is a man of the people, but he is also a man, if you follow my meaning.
What did you say?
I said Premier Kissoff is a degenerate atheist.
Mr. President, I formally request that you have his ignorant
proof. I'm sorry.
Mr. President, I think they're trying the number.
Gentlemen, you can't fight in here. This is the war room. What is going on here? I demand an explanation.
This clumsy fool tried to plant that ridiculous camera on me.
Yeah, you bet your sweets, Mr. Commie. Look at this, Mr. President. This lousy commie rat was taking pictures with this thing of the big board.
Mr. Ambassador.
This clumsy fool attempted to plant that ridiculous camera on me.
That's a damn lie. I saw him with my own eyes.
Miss Gentlemen, this is outrageous. I have never heard of such behavior in the war room before.
Mr. President, I think they're getting him on the line.
Those commies.
Yeah.
Gee, those trucks sure look like the real thing, don't they?
I wonder where they got them from.
Probably bought them from the army as war surplus.
Okay. Open up at 200 yards.